Learn more on BBC Bitesize.
Hello and welcome to BBC Bitesize GCSE Physics. I'm James Stewart, a TV presenter and climate expert, and I'm here to help you with your physics and combined science GCSE. In this video, we'll be exploring electricity and energy for your exam. I'm positively charged with excitement, so let's get started. When we talk about how electricity flows, there are two important C's to remember: charge and current. Let's look at our first C, the Mediterranean Sea. That's the wrong lesson, isn't it? Next time. Well, back to you. Let's look at our first C, which is charge. There are two types of electric charge, positive and negative. Charged particles, such as electrons, can transfer electrical energy. In metals, these charged particles are delocalized electrons that are free to move through the whole structure. Lucky them. Electrons are, of course, negatively charged. Feel free to scroll back and watch that bit again if you need to. Now let's talk about our second C, current. Electrical current is what we call the flow of electrically charged particles, such as electrons, as they move through an electrical conductor. It's how electrical energy flows through a circuit. We measure currents in amps using an ammeter. It measures the number of electrons passing through a point in a circuit in just 1 second. The current is the same at any point in a circuit, so long as it's a single closed loop. There are three types of current: direct, alternating, and these. But these currents are actually totally irrelevant to science. They are just dried grapes, delicious as they are. So actually, really, there's only two types of current: direct currents and alternating currents. A direct current is when the electrons just flow in one direction around a circuit. Here is an example. In a direct current, the electric current will move from negative on your battery or cell to positive. An alternating current, on the other hand, is a current where the direction of the electron flow continually reverses like this. Lovely. The easiest way to remember the difference between the two currents actually is through their names. Direct current takes one direct route and does not change direction. An alternating current, well, that alternates in direction. Which is a lot, isn't it? Phew, we've got through that. But can you remember the difference between direct and alternating currents? Feel free to pause the video, take a moment to think about it, and treat yourself to one of 700 currents. I'll do this while you do that. We'll be here for a very long time. And for a more in-depth look at electrical currents, as I eat a current, head over to the BBC Bitesize website. The link is below. Goodbye. Okay, now we've got the current flowing, let's talk resistance. Imagine you're trying to run through a crowded hallway full of people. Those people are like resistance, slowing you down. In electrical terms, resistance is the opposition to the flow of the current. This tiny component is a resistor, and its job is to limit the current flowing through a circuit. The higher the resistance, the less current actually gets through. Resistance is measured in ohms, and Ohm's law gives us a very handy equation to calculate. Voltage, V, current, I, and resistance, R, gives us V equals I times R. So if you know any two of these values, you can calculate the third. It is the ultimate electrical cheat sheet, and we love it. To find out more about ohms and resistance, head to the BBC Bitesize website. All the info you need is below. Enjoy. So let's see if you took all of that in and put your knowledge of Ohm's law to the test. I'll measure the voltage across this resistor and the current flowing through it. See if you can get it right too. So let's take a look at the measurements for this circuit. So we have the voltage, which is 12 volts, and the current, which is I, is 3 amps. So our resistance is voltage, which is 12, divided by the current, which is 3. 12 divided by 3 is 4. So the resistance in this circuit would be 4 ohms. This kind of calculation helps engineers and electricians design circuits safely, ensuring the right amount of resistance is used to control the current flow. Lovely stuff. For more electrifying information, head over to the BBC Bitesize website. The link's below. I'm frazzled. Is that electric? Is that electric fans? Not really, is it? No. I'll try harder. So there you have it. Hopefully you feel a bit more prepared for your physics and combined science GCSE. And if you want to find out even more about electricity or any other modules for your physics exam, then of course head over to the BBC Bitesize website. The link is below. And I'll see you next time. Bye.
For in-depth GCSE resources and practice, visit BBC Bitesize now.